that Steve Jobs is actually forced to resign from his own company. I have always been interested in Steve and have recently completed the research around his life. Without Steve, Apple would not be the huge technological company it is today. I will discuss the childhood, education, career, and achievements of American inventor Steve Jobs. According to the article entitled Childhood of Steve Jobs, he was born on February 24, 1955 in San Francisco, California. He was adopted at birth by Paul and Carol Jobs. And at five, the family moved to Mountain View, California. Steve always had a hard time in school. He didn't exactly fit in. He was forced to move to many different schools during his childhood because of problems with bullying. As a young kid, Steve always wanted to do something in technology. And whenever he found out that one of his neighbors worked at the AP computer company, he started spending all his time in his neighbor's garage looking at the new computers the company planned to roll out. He eventually became part of the HP Sports Club. He worked his way up to an internship with the HP and met his future co-worker, Steve Wozniak. College didn't fit Steve Jobs either. And according to Jason Feld and Carolyn Sun's article, Steve Jobs, an extraordinary career, Jobs dropped out of Berkeley College to work at Atari as a video game designer. After his work at Atari, Jobs and Wozniak started the Apple Computer Company, later named Apple Incorporated in 1975. Jobs would be the entrepreneur and Wozniak would be the producer of the company. Ironically, the now successful company started in Steve's parents' garage when Steve was only 21 years old. Jobs and Wozniak's first product was the Apple One. It was a desktop computer that they had to hand build themselves. They generated enough money from the Apple One to start producing the Apple II in 1977. The Apple II was a real breakthrough in computer technology. It was the first personal computer to have color graphics and a keyboard. It was instantly a success. First year sales made $3 million for the company, and 2 years later, the sales climbed to $200 million. After the introduction of the Apple II and the sales started to decline. And then Jobs eventually started to clash with the Apple's board of directors. Jobs was stripped of all his power forced to resign from the company he created 10 years earlier. Jobs created Next Computer Company while he was away and acquired Big Star Animation Studios. With Jobs away from the company, Apple's PC market share dropped to a low of 5.3% because they couldn't develop a next generation Macintosh. In a daring move, Apple Company decided to buy Next Computer Company and reappoint Jobs and Apple's board of directors. Jobs quickly became the CEO after Gilbert Amelio resigned from the company because the company was failing. Jobs then created the iMac, which miraculously brought the company back into profitability. Apple was still very successful today, even after the death of 56-year-old Steve Jobs in October 2011. Steve Jobs was responsible for many achievements, but a few stand out more than the rest. He is credited with igniting the personal computer revolution, and without Jobs, computers would be much different today. He invented the computer mouse and a graphical user interface, which really helped develop computers. If you're modernized in any way, you probably have a smartphone. Not only did he create the famed iPhone, but Jobs also started the smartphone age altogether. I have provided you with the highlights of the childhood, education, career, and achievements of American inventor Steve Jobs. And Steve Jobs' life proves that